Okay, moving like the clappers, guys. Again, we're just going to slap it on. It's already starting to gel. Lay that on. I can feel the heat coming off, so we're hot, baby. Yeah, we've got smoke even coming out of this now.
Self-destruct sequence has initiated. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Yeah, it's gone. Forget about that, guys. Overdone it with the hard nut, and it's smoking even. Actually going to be my ride plate, the back of the board. So I want a piece on one side at the minute. Everything gets a coat of black. Pop that on. Alright, guys, put a flat board down because I want this piece nice and flat. And then this is some non-stick cooking film. I'm going to put this over the top without moving it about. And then another weight of some sort of board, flat board, on the top. Just stick it on, don't touch it. You can always add a bit of weight, couple of cans on there. So we've got our piece, that's our upper rear section, but you see why I leave stuff square at the back. For instance, I cut that excess off there, and then it's a case of just putting a piece on that back section. It's all in stages, but I found that's the way to go with this stuff. I'm gonna be digging out my little ovals for the handles to go in. All right, these are gonna get a bit of carbon cleaned up, fresh off the printer. I'm just gonna dig in with a Dremel with a rotary head. I tried a potato peeler. I thought, well, maybe that'll just shift a bit off in layers, but not really. Now, basically I just want it nice and curved in because I want that to sit in there deep enough to not have this thing sticking out. It'll look a bit wrong, won't it, like that. On we go, let's rock and roll. This goes in here nicely. They're bigger than I need because there's carbon and stuff going in there. I've got the inserts to put in to screw this in. It sits down now fairly low, doesn't look too bad. Just for something to sort of lay on, grab. I've got the other sides dug out also. Print the other handle, so I've got two to play with at the same time so I can set both in. So I've got to do that, I've got to print the other one. The hatches, they came out okay. I've got the two locks that are going to go on the hatch, probably up the front, because I've got this thing at the back here. And I'm going to make a couple of bars or something that slips out here to put underneath this to secure the hatch, and then it will flop down and fold up. You know, we're getting there. These little bits here, fiddly diddlies, then it will be carbon in the hole. Board, you know, after a bit of a clean up here and there with some light paper, I'll be back once I've done a bit more and I'll show you the result of that. All right, righty people, hello, how are you doing? Yeah, so basically I'm going to mold this few bits of carbon into this mold here that'll attach to the back of my hatch to slip underneath the where the jet drives are. Hope you're enjoying these videos, guys. You know, I'm trying to make them interesting. If there's certain things you don't know, hopefully in one of the videos you will know. So I've got this mold. I'm gonna make a couple of curvy bits. Quite a bit of resin here. Basically done one big one, and I'll cut after into two. Just need two pieces sticking out the back of my hatch here. Another bit of resin on top of that lot there. Yeah, a lot of this board has just been kind of ideas, you know, how can I do this or that. And it's all about the steps you take. The worst thing would be to have to break something out. Do it nice or do it twice, that's my little saying. You also got the 6 P's, prior preparation prevents piss poor performance. If you live your life a little bit by that, you can't really go far wrong, you know. I've got resin between all the layers, and I'll get the other part, push that in there. All right, that's pushed together, giving me a sandwich. A sandwich.
Self-destruct sequence has initiated.
Right, Waysiders. I made this mould on the last little clip here. I forgot to put my protective film on this stuff here, which is a non-stick film. But the main mistake I made here, guys, was I wanted the flange, this piece here, on the other side, on the roundy bit. So I put it all together, then sat there and thought, hang on, that's going on the wrong way. And you'll see what I mean. That mould, a little bit of a test trial. Then I went in, made the new mould using this film. You can buy it in a supermarket, I guess, or somewhere. And it's a non-stick film. It peels off beautifully. So I knocked this mould up and put a new one together quickly. And I thought I'd break it open for you. This will come open fairly well. So it's just this back corner, there we go. So there you go, you put your film on and then the bloody mould doesn't stick to the thing, does it? You see this flange here? I wanted it up on the top. So, just peels off. It's a bit like peel ply. It's only a few bucks and you can reuse it. So here we go, this is where this bit will stick because I've probably got resin behind it now. Always, isn't it, when you're on camera, eh? The foam bin, no problem. You see, two bits of plastic pipe clamped together and I've got my part. All right, I'll clean off that little bit of foam there, a bit of resin seepage. So I've got my hatch. This will be two of these, all cut down lovely jubbly, stick it out like that, smaller than that obviously, and that will fit under the back, that back section. Right, that was that. And then I've got this little puppy over here. This is for the other hatch, the middle hatch. Again with the peel ply, but this time behind as well. So that was just two bits of foam bent into an L, you know, easy. Comes off the back the same, yeah. We all like a peel, guys, don't we? Peels off like a dream. And that gives me an elbow. It's not perfect. It's literally cutting these to shape and everything, getting them looking good, and then sticking it in to the back of the hatch. There we go, that's my two parts now I've got molded. I can crack on, which is awesome. Awesome. So here we go, I'll leave you there with that one. Likey likes, lovely jobs. All right, see you later, Waysiders.